Welcome to Insight e-learning course. I'm Fiaz Abbas, and in this video we are going to talk about Quick Action Toolbar. Quick Action Toolbar is a pretty handy toolbar and we are going to discuss about it. First of all, I would like you to download these practice files if you haven't downloaded them yet. And then an open document, failure is a tuition, you pay for success. In this video, I'm going to explain you Quick Action Toolbar. This row above the command tab row is a quick action toolbar row. This is a list of quick action toolbar. This is the save button that you can further see over here. This is the save button if you want to save something, right? This is a, we will be practicing them one by one in the later files. And this is when we want to repeat some action, right? And this is we use when we want to read a text. I'm going to just tell you everything one by one. For example, I apply, for example, size and color to it. When I apply color to it, I can quickly save this document to anywhere we want to. Click on the save button. The change that I apply to the sentence is automatically going to be saved in the document when I click on the save button right here in the quick action toolbar. And now the second button is undo button. When I click on it, all the actions that I have previously done would be neutralized, right? Now this, you can quickly do it by clicking on the redo button over here. And there's a second button that you can see over here. When you want to hear the speech of your written text, you can click on the speech button right here. Just clicking on it. When I click on it,
failure is the tuition you pay for success.
There you go. When you click on it, it automatically starts to speak. Now, if you want to create a blank document quickly, you can simply click on this blank document button right away. I just click in it and there you go. I've got a new blank document. So here, let's back to the same document. Now look at this small mountain that you can see here in the quick action toolbar. When you click on it in the quick action toolbar, this button is used to customize quick action toolbar. For example, you decide which button you want to place in the quick action list or which you don't. So here, when I click on undo, undo immediately is going to be disappeared from the quick action list. When I click on this little mountain again, I can click on the undo again. And you see, I have my undo button back again. You can also click on it to show it below the ribbon. For example, when I click on it, you can see my quick action toolbar list has moved to a new location below the ribbon that you can see more clearly. Let me zoom a bit. There you go. This is my, get back to my where I was. I should want it to be shown under the ribbon. Just go to the little mountain and click on the show above the ribbon. And there you go. It has come back. It has come back again. And you can see over here. For example, you want some features or button that are not enlisted in the quick access toolbar, you can click on more commands. When you click on more commands, here is a list of all the buttons that you can use in a quick access toolbar. You just, for example, I want a color highlighter in my quick action toolbar. When I click on text highlights color, for example, here, and then I click on add the button, I have my wished button appeared here, as you can see. When I click on OK, as you can see, this button has been added into my quick toolbar. Now, what if I don't want a particular button to be appeared in the quick action toolbar? Just click on any of the button and then just click on remove from quick access toolbar. There you go. Pretty awesome. And now, I would like you to come back and never forget to attend the fourth lecture, which is very important and fundamental for your learning. See you until the next lecture.